Hi friends, welcome to Shankaran IAS Study Circle. This is Manjula here. Okay, coming to today's multiple choice questions, I will discuss 5 multiple choice questions related to today. Okay, before starting this MCQ, let me tell you something. Due to some anxiety and fear, I am not able to give my full potential in this particular videos, but with due course of time, I will improve myself and I will give my best. Please keep supporting me and encouraging me. Okay, we will start then. Coming to first question, AUKUS Tripartite Security Alliance is among which of the following countries? Option 1, Africa, United States, Russia. Option 2, Australia, United Kingdom, United States. Option 3, Australia, Uzbekistan, United States. Option 4, Asian countries, United Kingdom, United States. Answer for this particular question is Australia, United Kingdom and United States. I will discuss in detail what is this AUKUS Tripartite Security. Here the term A is for Australia, UK is for United Kingdom and US for United States of America. And this is the alliance which was announced by USA recently. It's a tripartite alliance among these countries, mainly to transfer or to give nuclear submarine technology to Australia. Its major aim and main theme of this alliance is to transfer or provide nuclear submarine technology to Australia. And going insights about what is the main aim of this AUKUS Tripartite Security is, it focuses mainly on Indo-Pacific region. Here, for your better understanding, I'll show you the map. In this map, this green shaded area is the countries of AUKUS Tripartite Alliance. This is UK, this is UK, this is USA, and this is Australia. Why the USA is supporting or providing nuclear submarine only for Australia? Because it is, but the USA is not telling what's their exact reason in direct manner, but its indirect aim is to fight against China, which is playing major role in South China Sea. This is South China Sea, right? Here, China is playing a very major role in this South China Sea. To oppose this activities, the USA is, or to counter this dominance of Chinese presence in this South China Sea, the USA is providing assistance or providing some nuclear submarine technology to Australia to counter the activities of China in this particular area. That's the reason it is providing nuclear submarine technology to Australia. That's the main motto of this tripartite alliance. And coming to one more point, along with USA, UK and Australia, there is, along with this, there is some other country, two more countries like Canada and New Zealand. While this few 5 countries form an alliance called 5 Eyes Alliance. 5 Eyes Alliance is nothing but, it is an alliance between USA, UK, Australia, Canada and New Zealand. When this alliance was formed, it was formed during Cold War period. In that period, it's an indirect war between Russia and USA, which you people are already familiar with. At that time, it was formed with the aim to share the knowledge or intelligence of adversaries so that they can fight among the alliances. That's the reason the Five Eyes Alliance was formed, and it is one of the most important and world's most successful intelligence alliance. Five Eyes Alliance. There may be a question in competitive exams like Five Eyes Alliance is related to which of the following? They may give it is related to, now you can easily answer, it is related to Cold War period. It's a main aim is to share intelligence solution. Same in this Five Eyes Alliance, three countries now formed this AUKUS Tripartite Security Alliance. Hope you understood this. And this is also a multi-sectoral cooperation. Means these countries will share knowledge and other things related to artificial intelligence, information technology and many other sectors. They'll share their knowledge among these countries. This is all about AUKUS Tripartite Security Alliance. And coming to one more point regarding this, Australia is the only country, non-nuclear country, to have nuclear weapons or nuclear related technology now, which will use for other than civilian purpose. It's the non-nuclear country. That's the main reason. And USA did not support or provide or transfer nuclear technology in the past years. This is the second time. And during 1950s, it provided or it transferred nuclear technology for the first time to UK. And this is the second instance of providing nuclear technology to Australia. Kindly remember this. This is the second instance. Why it's mainly providing this nuclear technology to Australia? Its main motto is it should indirectly counter the Chinese activities in South China Sea. That's the reason it is providing nuclear submarine technology to Australia. But the USA is not revealing its intention of providing this security. This is all about AUKUS Tripartite Security Alliance. We'll go for next question. Coming to second question, in context of contribution to national exports, what is the position of Andhra Pradesh in 2021? Why this particular news is, why particularly this national exports is in news? Because yesterday, the Andhra Pradesh Chief Minister Y.S. Jagan Mohan Reddy launched a 2 days event called Export, like with the aim to encourage exports. 2 days event to encourage exports. That event is known as Vanijya Utsav is the 2 day event organized or launched by the Andhra Pradesh Chief Minister Jagan Mohan Reddy Garu. Its main motto is to encourage more exports and to become a lead state among the other states in the country. Now the contribution to total national exports is, it got increased by 19.53% in the year 2019-20. And this event was organized under the commemoration of 75 years of independence. This event was organized by Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh under the commemoration of 75 years of independence. Like this is an achievement part of 75 years of independence. And the growth rate in this particular year is 19.53. Though we faced a pandemic situation, but it's a good rate and it's an achievement. Like it's the growth rate in exports. Kindly remember this. This is the Vanijya Utsav. And the place of Andhra Pradesh in the year 2021 is fourth place. While in the year 2018-19 is 9th place. This is an achievement, right? Though state faced a pandemic situation, but still it is improving its exports and the cultivation is at good level. This is all about this national exports. This, and one more thing you have to remember is recently at the place called Kopparthi in Kadapa district of Andhra Pradesh, Chief Minister is aiming to launch an industrial mega park in Kopparthi in Kadapa district. Kindly remember this. This is also a fact which is important for your competitive exams, that is related to State Public Service Commission. Kopparthi is the place where the industrial mega park will be established through the time. This is all about this national exports. Kindly remember which place now Andhra Pradesh is. This is all about this national exports and the place of Andhra Pradesh. Next, we'll go for next question. Which of the following committee headed the national curriculum framework? Option 1, Kasturi Rangan Committee. Option 2, Gadgil Committee. Option 3, Subramanian Committee. Option 4, Naresh Chandra Committee. Answer for this particular question is Kasturi Rangan Committee. Actually, I hope you people have already heard about this committee, because the same committee was headed the panel for the protection of Western Ghats. So, hope you people are familiar with this committee. This committee and Gadgil committee combinedly headed the previous committee for the protection of Western Ghats also. The same Kasturi Rangan committee now headed the national curriculum framework. Now, who is this Kasturi Rangan means? He is the former chairman of ISRO. He headed this National Curriculum Framework Committee. How many members will be there in this particular committee? There will be 12 member committee, and the tenure given for this committee, the term given for this committee to complete this particular curriculum work is 3 years. Kindly remember even this also, and how many members consist of this National Curriculum Framework? 12 members. And this main aim is to prepare National Curriculum Framework. Usually in the past years, the state curriculum framework will be also there at state level, and the national curriculum framework will be there at central level. Usually the state curriculum framework will follow the guidelines of this national curriculum framework. But what's the change in this particular national curriculum framework in this year is, its main aim is it will take suggestions from them, means they will not order, they will take suggestions from them so that they can have wide knowledge of all the states and they will consider it. It is also one of the thing which may lead to federation, means they are cooperating among the states and then they will decide the particular curriculum and it will be followed all throughout the India. This is the better option, I can say. Though the center is framing the particular curriculum and saying the states to follow that particular, better to take suggestions from them also and to inculcate those suggestions in this national curriculum framework. So in this curriculum, they will take suggestions from state curriculum framework. This is about national curriculum framework. You actually in the past it was amended last in 2005 under UPA government. Now again it is laying out guidelines to change school textbooks and school textbooks and syllabus according to present scenario, and even they will include all technology and all this pandemic situation and the implications of pandemic situations, and it will also consult with NCERT and CSERT. What is this NCERT? National Council for Education and Research and Training. This is same, but here it is State Council for Education, Research and Training. They will consult these organizations and they will take their decisions to improve, or they will provide the guidelines to improve the school education, and they will also provide the guidelines not only for the teachers, they will provide the guidelines for adult children and the early childhood. All they will provide the guidelines for all level of students, from teachers to the students. They will provide all guidelines to all members in this particular national curriculum framework. This is the main aim of this national curriculum framework. This is Subramanyam committee. Let me discuss these two committees also. What is this relate? What is this committee is set up for? Subramanyam committee is set up for the main aim to for the evolution of national education policy. Means this committee itself suggested for the implementation or the evolution of national education policy, and this national curriculum framework is part of national education policy. And what's the main aim of our Prime Minister Modi is to provide and to have a new curriculum for all the schools throughout the country by 2022, when we people are celebrating 75 years of independence. That's the main aim of our Prime Minister Modi ji. That's the reason this curriculum framework is set up recently, and this is the very recent news. Coming to this Naresh Chandra committee, this committee was set up for the corporate affairs. Means this committee will collect the corporate affairs related matters under this committee. That's the reason this committee was set up, and this is all related to this national curriculum framework. Just I gave you as other option in this particular question. This is all about this particular question. I'll go for next question. Kindly remember all those facts. Who will be appointed as the new chief of air staff? Answer for this particular question is B.R. Chaudhary. Here option 1 is R.K.S. Badauria, option 2 is V.R. Chaudhary, option 3 Thomas L. Mihir, option 4 Birendra Singh. Now answer for this particular question is V.R. Chaudhary. Now but he was suggested by them, and he still not took place as the new chief of the air staff. He will take the position after September 31st, after the retirement of the present person. Who is the present person? The present person is R.K.S. Badauria. He is the present chief of air staff. Now we'll go into some insights of who is this chief of the air staff. This chief of the air staff was formed in the year 26th January 1950. This is the formation day of the chief of air staff. He is the highest officer of Indian Air Force, and he is the head of the governing body related to Air Force matters, and he will lead all the matters related to Air Force. And what is the tenure of this particular chief of Air Force is 3 years, or till he attained the age of 62. Why this particular person is selected as the chief of air staff? What is his achievements? Let me discuss here. His achievement are, he took a major role in two missions like Operation Meghdoot. This took place in and around 1980s. Here he supported air force in this particular operation Meghdoot to capture the Siachen glacier area. And in one more mission he was participated, that name is Operation Safed Sagar. He played a major role in this Operation Safed Sagar also. This took place in the year 1990. What is this Operation Safed Sagar mean? In this, he provided Indian Air Force to support or to fight in Kargil War. This is related to Kargil War. Means he played a major role in both these operations, and he had many achievements and many success roles in this all operations and all missions. That's the reason he was selected as the Chief of Air Staff. This is all about the new Chief of Air Staff. Kindly remember this name, which is important for all competitive exams. This is all about new Chief of Air Staff. It is a 12 member. No, this is not 12 members, sorry. This is about Chief of Air Staff. Okay, I forgot to tell you one more fact. Here, Thomas L. Mehert is the first Air Chief. This also may be a question. Kindly remember this also. He is the first Chief of Air Staff. This is all about this particular Thomas L. Mehert is the first Chief of Air Staff. Now we'll go for last question. Ek Pahal campaign is related to which of the following means for what reason this campaign is going for. Now we'll go for options: LPG gas cylinder distribution, food and processing sector, justice delivery, banking service. The answer for this question is justice delivery. You people may also confuse this name because there is the scheme. This is the campaign, right? Ek Pahal campaign. There is also one more scheme named as Pahal scheme. Its main aim is to provide or distribute LPG gas cylinder at subsidized rate. The name is same, right? So you people can get confused with this. Kindly remember, Ek Pahal campaign is different from Pahal scheme. Ek Pahal campaign is related to justice delivery. It comes under the Union Ministry of Law and Justice. And who is the Union Ministry of Law and Justice now? Kiran Rijju. He is the Union Ministry of Law and Justice. This campaign comes under this Kiran Rijju. What is the main aim of this Ek Pahal campaign is to deliver justice and to make aware of the people about telelaw. What is telelaw? Telelaw means with the use of artificial intelligence, communications and information technology, they will utilize that particular information technology and they will make aware of the people about the legal services, and they will advise the people how to approach the legal services and to utilize this legal offices. Means it's an e-interaction between the lawyers and the people through video conferencing and to resolve their disputes through telelaw. Means it's an video conferencing between the people and lawyers to resolve the disputes. This is all about this E-Pahal campaign. Yeah, kindly remember under which ministry it comes. It comes under Union Minister of Law and Justice. Who is the Union Ministry for Law and Justice? Kiran Rijju. This is all about today's multiple choice questions. Hope you understood. If you people have any doubts, kindly tell us in the comment section. This is all about today's news. Hope you understood. Thank you.